After Boris Johnson's conference speech, this is what we're supposed to all be angry about.
And I know that it's the instinct of the people of this country, like the people of Ukraine, to choose freedom every time. I can give you a couple of famous recent examples. When the British people voted for Brexit.
Yeah, sure, he's likening people who are currently fighting to keep their kids from being blown up to people who voted for Brexit. And when you flip that around, he's also implying that anybody who opposes Brexit will be more likely to support Russia, which is ironic for a number of reasons. But Boris Johnson saying disgustingly offensive stuff isn't new and it isn't news. I want to focus on two things. One, the hypocrisy, because it's important to compare what Boris Johnson says with what he does, and also freedom, because, well, it came up.
Freedom, freedom, freedom. That's called freedom. Freedom, freedom, freedom. So we just want to be free. Freedom, 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 freedom under the law. Freedom, freedom.
Johnson is setting himself and his party up as the champions of freedom in opposition to the oppression of Putin's Russia.
It's conservatives who stand up for freedom against the blackmail of Vladimir Putin. And that's why talented people are fleeing Russia, quite frankly, right now. And that's why they're flocking to the UK.
Which is where the hypocrisy comes in, because how has British freedom been doing since Boris and Brexit took over? Let's start with his examples.
Because in Putin's Russia, you get jailed for 15 years just for calling an invasion.
Wasn't it your party that proposed locking up journalists for 14 years if they embarrassed the government? And the journalist in Russia who recently called the invasion an invasion by interrupting a public broadcaster, she could have been sent to jail for up to 10 years if you did that here under your new policing bill. Not to mention the anti-war protesters who were shouting loudly outside the Kremlin in Moscow, they could be fined up to £2,500 under your new law.
And in Ukraine, they have free elections.
If you really care about voting freedom, why are you making voting harder for the 2 million people who don't have photo ID, knowing this will disproportionately affect young people who are less likely to have driving licenses and passports, and are also less likely to vote Tory? Funny that. And don't forget, his reason for likening Ukrainians fighting Putin to the 52% voting Brexit was that they both did so because
they wanted to be free.
But Brexit means British people no longer have the automatic right to work in 30 European countries, so I doubt touring musicians feel very free, or the half of UK businesses that are struggling to sell to the EU, or the fishermen that can't sell their fish, or the farmers that can't sell their pigs, or Northern Ireland that can't vote on the EU laws that it still has to follow. But according to you,
that's called freedom.
And now you're trying to put traveller and gypsy people in jail, even though the police have said they'd rather just use fines, which means you're even less pro-freedom than the people whose job it is to lock people up. Then there's this.
And I have a bream, as they say. I have a dream, a vision of a one nation conservatism.
Now, while it's lovely to hear a guy who the United Nations accused of normalizing white supremacy quoting Martin Luther King, I find it interesting that in the same speech, he supported the stop and search provisions of the policing bill.
Stopping and searching the kids with the knives, giving the police the powers that they need.
Especially when the Home Office itself says it will disproportionately impact black people. MLK would be so proud. And when bragging about how he's standing up to Putin.
I know there are some around the world who say that we're better off making accommodations with tyranny. I have to say, I believe they are profoundly wrong.
Last week, Saudi Arabia chopped the heads off 81 people. This week, Boris Johnson visited the Saudi prince to beg him for oil, while at the same time selling him the weapons he's using to bomb hospitals and schools in Yemen. If that's not accommodating tyranny, I'd hate to see the footage of what accommodating him looks like. Basically, Johnson is reducing the UK's freedom of the press, freedom of expression, freedom to vote, freedom to protest, privacy freedom, freedom from discrimination, and freedom of movement, while acting like he's William Wallace in the face of Russian dictatorship.